Hello scholars, welcome back. I hope you all are doing fine. Today we are going to start with grade 7 new images, lesson 8, that is the boy with the catapult, which is written by Bhisham Sahani. Let's read out the introduction of the writer on page number 80. Bhisham Sahani was a Hindi writer, playwright and actor most famous for his novel and television screenplay Tamas, a powerful and passionate account of the partition of India. He was awarded the Padma Bhushan for literature in 1998 and the Sahitya Academy Fellowship in 2002. The Boy with a Catapult is taken from a rare collection of short stories. The Best 13, published in 1983. The 13 stories are from 13 different languages of India. Some of the stories in the collection are The Special Prize, The Hungry Septopus, Adal Badal, The Exchange and The Boy with a Catapult. So, this is a story about a boy whose heart changes at the end. Let's start reading the story on page number 81. Our class at school had an odd assortment of boys. Here the word assortment means mixed collection. But the oddest boy in the school was Bodhraj. And this is the story about the boy Bodhraj. We were all afraid of him. If he pinched anyone's arm, the arm would swell up as if from snake bite. So everybody was very much afraid of this boy Bodhraj, and also when he used to pinch anyone, it used to swell up like as if it is of snake bite. He was utterly callous. He would catch a wasp with his bare fingers, pull out its sting, tie a thread around it and fly it like a kite. He would pounce on a butterfly sitting on a flower and crush it between his fingers, or else stick a pin through it and pin it to his notebook. So he was very insensitive towards small insects and everyone. He used to just catch them and fly them as a kite, or he used to pin them in his notebook. It was said that if a scorpion stung Bodhraj, the scorpion would fall dead. Bodhraj's blood was believed to be so full of venom that even snake bite had no effect on him. So it was believed that his blood was full of venom. Venom means poison, that even the snake bite had no effect on his body. He always had a catapult in his hand and was an excellent shot. His favorite targets were birds. He would stand under a tree, take aim, and the next moment bird cries would rend the air and a fluff of feathers would float down. So, as you all might have seen a catapult, it is a kind of device in which we put stones or pebbles and we make a shot. So, he was very experienced to use that device, that is known as catapult, and his targets were birds and all. He used to just aim at the birds. Or else, he would climb up a tree, take away the eggs and destroy the nest. He was vindictive and took pleasure in hurting others. So he enjoyed destroying the nest of the birds and he was vindictive. Vindictive means he was always in desire to hurt other people and he used to get immense pleasure in hurting other people. All the boys were scared of him. Even his mother called him a Rakshas. His pockets bulged with strange things. A live parrot, an assortment of eggs or a prickly hedgehog. If Bodhraj quarreled with anyone, he would charge at him head on like a bull, or viciously kick and bite him. So everybody was very scared of him, and he used to carry very strange things in his pocket, like a live parrot, or he used to carry so many eggs and all. So like everybody was scared to see all these things. After school, we would return home, but Bodhraj would be on his wanderings. That means when everybody used to go back home after the school, but Bodhraj used to wander here and there. He used to just roam here and there. My father was given a promotion in his job, and we moved into a large bungalow. It was an old style bungalow on the outskirts of the city. So here the narrator is telling that as his father got promotion, so they moved to a large bungalow which was on the outskirts of the city. It had brick floors, high walls, a slanting roof, and a garden full of trees and shrubs. Though comfortable, it seemed rather empty and big. And being far from the city, my friends seldom came to visit me. So the narrator is telling that when they went to the outskirts of the city, so his friends never visited him, means they visited very less. Now, let's start reading from page number 82. The only exception was Bodhraj. He found it a good hunting ground. So, the narrator is telling that none of his friends used to visit him, but Bodhraj used to come there as it was a good hunting ground. That means hunting could be done there. The trees had many nests. Monkeys roamed about, and under the bushes lived a pair of mongooses. Behind the house, there was a big room where my mother stored our extra luggage. This room had become a haunt of pigeons. That means lot of pigeons were there. You could hear them cooing all day. Near the broken glass of the ventilator, there was a mynah's nest. The floor of the room was littered with feathers, bird droppings, broken eggs, and bits of straw from nests. So that room was full of eggs, bird droppings, etc., because there was mynah's nest and also the pigeons used to live there. My mother did not approve of my friendship with Bodhraj, but she realized that I was lonely and needed company. So, narrator's mother did not like the friendship of her son with Bodhraj, and she realized that he is lonely, and so she said it's okay. One day, my mother said to me, "If your friend is so fond of destroying nests, tell him to clean our storeroom." So, narrator's mother told that Bodhraj is always keeping on hunting the birds and all, so please tell him to clean our storeroom. The birds have made it very filthy. Filthy means very dirty. I protested. You said it's cruel to destroy nest. I didn't suggest he should kill the birds. He can remove the nest without harming them. The next time Bodhraj came, I took him to the godown. It was dark and smelly, as though we had entered an animal's lair. So, the next time when Bodhraj came to narrator's house, so the narrator took him to the godown. I confess, I was somewhat worried. What if, true to form, Bodhraj destroyed the nest, pulled out the birds' feathers, and broke their eggs? So here, the narrator was worried and thinking that what is going to happen if Bodhraj is going to destroy the bird's nest and the feathers are going to come out, and if he is going to break their eggs. Bodhraj had brought his catapult. He studied the position of the nest under the roof. Near the ventilator was the mynah's nest. I could see bits of cotton wool and rag hanging out. Some pigeons strutted up and down a beam, cooing to one another. The miner's little ones are up there, said Bodhraj, aiming with his catapult. I noticed two tiny yellow beaks peeping out of the nest. So they could notice that there were little ones of the miner and they were in the nest and peeping out of the nest. Look, Bodhraj exclaimed, this is a Ganga miner. It isn't usually found in these areas. Where are the parents? I asked. Must have gone in search of food. They should be back soon. Bodhraj raised his catapult. I wanted to stop him, but before I could open my mouth, there was a whizzing sound and then a loud clang as the pebble hit the iron sheet of the roof. The tiny beaks vanished, the cooing and tittering ceased. It seemed as if all the birds have been frightened into silence. So suddenly there was silence all around. Bodhraj left fly another pebble. This time it struck a beam. Bodhraj was proud of his aim, but he had missed his target twice and was very angry with himself. So when Bodhraj missed the target, so he was getting very angry at himself because he used to consider himself as very experienced person to use a catapult. When the chicks peeped over the rim of the nest, Bodhraj had a third try. This time the pebble hit the side of the nest. A few straws and bits of cotton wool fell, but the nest was not dislodged. So when he tried for the third time also, the pebble went at the side of the nest and nothing happened to the nest. Bodhraj lifted his catapult again. Suddenly, a large shadow flitted across the room, blocking the light from the ventilator. Startled, we looked up. Gazing down at us menacingly was a large kite with its wings outstretched. The minor chicks began fluttering their wings and shrieking loudly. What would the kite do? The kite left the ventilator and perched on a rafter. It had folded back its wings. It shook its craggy neck and peered to the right and to the left. The birds' frightened cries filled the air. So, as you know, that kite is also a bird. So, when this bird was flying here and there, so the minor chicks were getting very frightened. They were very scared. The kite has been coming here every day, said Bodhraj. I realized why broken wings, straw and bits of bird flesh littered the floor. The kite must have ravaged the nest often. So Bodhraj said that this kite has been coming here daily and now I realize why there are broken wings and all the things lying here and there. Bodhraj had not taken his eyes off the kite, which was slowly moving towards the nest. The cries became shriller. I was a bundle of nerves. Bodhraj raised his catapult and aimed at the kite. Now, let's read out on page number 84. Don't hit the kite, it will attack you, I shouted. But Bodhraj paid no attention. So here the narrator is telling to Bodhraj that don't hit the kite as it is going to attack you. The pebble missed the kite and hit the ceiling. The kite spread its wing wide and peered down. Let's get out of here, I said, frightened. The kite will eat up the little ones. This sounded rather strange coming from him. Bodhraj aimed again. The kite left the rafter and spreading its wings flew in a semicircle and alighted on a beam. The chicks continued to scream. So the kite was still flying here and there in order to break the nest of the chicks and the chicks were screaming very loudly. Bodhraj handed me the catapult and some pebbles from his pocket. Aim at the kite. Go on hitting it. Don't let it sit down, he instructed. Then he ran and pulled up a table standing against the wall to the middle of the room. I didn't know how to use the catapult. I tried once, but the kite had left the beam and flown to another. So here Bodhraj told to the narrator that aim at the kite and keep on hitting it. But the narrator did not know how to use the catapult. Bodhraj brought the table right under the Myna's nest. Then he picked up a broken chair and placed it on the table. He climbed on the chair, gently lifted the nest and slowly stepped down. Let's get out of here, he said, and ran towards the door. I followed. We went into the garage. It had only one door and a small window in the back wall. So Bodhraj had brought the nest down and they took it to the garage and there was no door, so he said that the kite cannot get in here. The kite can't get in here, he said, and climbing onto a box placed the nest on a beam. The Myna's young head quietened down. Standing on the box, Bodhraj peeped into the nest. I thought he would pick them both up and put them in his pocket, as he usually did. So, narrator thought that now Bodhraj is going to pick up the birds and he is going to put them in his pocket as he usually used to do. But after looking at them for a long time, he said, "Bring some water. The chicks are thirsty. We'll put it drop by drop into their mouths." I bought a glass of water. Both the chicks, beaks open, were panting. Bodhraj fed them with drops of water. He told me not to touch them, nor did he touch them himself. How will their parents know they are here? I asked. They will look for them. We stayed in the garage for a long time. When Bodhraj came the next day, he had neither catapult nor pebbles. He carried a bag of seeds. We fed the Myna's young and spent hours watching their antics. Antics means playful tricks. So they saved the lives of the Myna chicks, and also we learned that Bodhraj changed his heart. Now, let us quickly revise what we studied in this video. So, this is a story, the boy with a catapult. And this is a story of a boy named Bodhraj who was very cruel. So, one day when the narrator shifted to the outskirts of the city, so Bodhraj used to go there and he was very fond of hunting the birds and destroying the nest. And we learned that Bodhraj used to enjoy hurting the other people or hurting the birds, etc. So one day when he went to the narrator's storeroom, he saw that there were straws and the nest, broken eggs lying down. And then he saw a kite flying there. Also, he saw that the Myna chicks were very scared because the bird, that is the kite, was flying here and there to destroy the nest. And so Bodhraj tries to save those Myna chicks. He brings them down and he takes them to the garage. Then from that day onwards, he stopped carrying his catapult. He stopped hurting the birds. And from that day, he started carrying the seeds along with him to feed the birds. So by this, we learned that how a cruel boy changes his heart and he becomes a very good person. I hope you all enjoyed the video. Assignments and worksheets are given in the description box. Keep practicing them. and we will be meeting in the next video. Till then, stay home, stay safe, keep washing your hands. Thank you.